Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. We are in House of Gains, which you will have seen once before. You've also seen Caitlin in that session. We are in for Push today. So another session you haven't seen, and few little tweaks that actually we've even just made to this session alone. Just as a result of where we're both at the moment, and I'll let Caitlin talk about where she's at in a minute. But we're sort of both at a point where we've kind of breached that comfortable off-season set point where both of our body weights are at a productive level to start to focus on the really hard stuff and put that sort of further up the session. Whereas in contest prep, there is definite benefits to having some potentiation, slight movements prior to your heavy compounds, partially for just effectiveness of the session, but also down to just the fact that the safety element of those compound movements starts to fade a little bit when you are very, very lean. So yeah, we're in a good position now where we can just go full send. That's what we said this morning.
Absolutely.
So actually let you update everyone first. So where are you at?
Yeah.
How's off season going?
So about 3.5 months post show now, which is flown by, to be fair. It's been a very productive phase for the most part. A little bit slow out of the gate, but now we're in like a really good groove. Weight is probably sitting about just under 10 kilos up, and I don't think we had that in mind. Like in my head, I had a certain amount that we sort of wanted to get to, but it's a completely different ball game. Like coming up this time round, looking at body weight last time compared to now, just completely different. So we're just focusing on training performance, which is flying.
Yeah.
And just the look rather than anything, which is I'm actually really happy with it. Obviously there's a lot more that can be done, but you know, for the amount of time that we've had post show, I'm really happy with what we've done, and the areas that we've been wanting to bring up definitely are sort of coming up.
Yeah.
So something's working, that's for sure.
Yeah. Sort of said at the start of this phase, just need to keep doing crazy stuff in the gym.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that. You know, people love to overcomplicate this stuff, and there is many ways to skin a cat. And if you like overanalyzing and thinking about the intricacies of bodybuilding, fair fucks. Sorry to swear, but like fair play. I and Caitlin, and I think the reason why we collaborate very well is we're very similar in the way that we like to train. We don't really like to overthink things too much. We like to do movements that feel good, that we can get really strong at, and that we're trying to do stuff that other people don't do and can't do. And that's inclusive of not just strength feats, but like silly sets like our 40 leg presses.
Yeah.
You know, stuff that I think that is very novel. You don't see it often, but has been done before and reaps the, like people can see that reaps rewards. So yeah, for me, I'm a little bit heavier than when we filmed the arm day, so I'm up another sort of 3 or 4 pounds. Had one of my first consult calls with Berto about sort of just how I'm gonna map out this off season. I'm definitely still very much in control of where this off season heads. So a lot of people ask, you know, have you sort of like get a weekly check-in with Berto? At the moment, it's not so much that, it's more so just I'll check in with him and have an hour call on Zoom every like 3 or 4 months. And he'll just say, right, cool, yeah, we're going in the right direction, or okay, what do you think about this? And then we'll come to like almost a collaborative decision as to where we head next. So there is maybe some trajectory in which we'll do a small diet at some point to go through some of his methods that you might want to use with me during prep. But my perspective is extend my time in a surplus as long as possible, because I'm a big believer in that. So if my biofeedback's good, if I'm training well, if I'm progressing, my body composition's okay, I'm just gonna keep pushing for as long as I can. And it's as simple as it gets. Sleeping lots, eating lots, and training well. So that's where we're at. You may see Loz in the background on a few bits. Alex, can you pan? Say hi.
Hi.
So she's still here. She's come along to sessions, stay part of the routine, but obviously still very much in the recovery process. And she will be back soon and stronger than ever in sessions, so you can look forward to that. But yeah, we're gonna crack on. Enjoy, guys.
Oh, okay.
So we actually had dumbbell lateral before the high incline for the last, well, to be honest, for quite a while. I'm now 11 weeks deep into this training setup, so we had it in all the time and all throughout prep. But like I said at the start, we've just got this sort of just stable environment now where we can go sort of more safely into our first press and probably start to make a little bit more progress, especially as how strong we're getting in laterals. Like last session I did 25 kilo dumbbell lateral raise for like 12 reps. And I'm not gonna lie, that was fairly fatiguing prior to the high incline. And I kind of want to get more out of the high incline, especially with us being in a progressive environment. So we'll see how that goes today. Even if you knock them perfectly, like you can't quite always keep that first rep the same. Sometimes it's the spotter's fault, sometimes it's your fault. So we've had good knocks and bad knocks, haven't we?
Yes. Yeah.
But I think, I don't know, it's almost like I would like to do it myself, but with these dumbbells especially, still getting used to them, I think the knock is worthwhile.
Oh,
because
my God, yeah.
The first rep, I mean, you've done it before on your own, it yeah. takes so much out of you. It's almost like not worth trying to just do it on your own for the sake of potentially actually hurting yourself as well.
Yeah, I know there's some people that say like you shouldn't do the weight if you can't knock up yourself, but I'd be pressing like the 25 max.
Uh-huh.
Which I know I can do like 10 plus reps on. So it's one of
at the end of the day, like how much real help can you have from this position with like yeah. just your hands as well,
especially
like,
if it's me and Kate that just
yeah.
Yeah, true. Like, but yeah, like you're not going to be curling. Like, you're not even in a curl position. I don't know. We're probably overthinking that. Probably should do our back offset. Just stop talking.
I don't know.
That's it. Yeah.
Now we go. Still fucking
powering.
Come on,
kid.
Show
me
the heart. Come on.
Oh. Yep!
Got you. Yep. Oh. Good. Yes. Yep. Let's go. Oh, yeah. Off we go now. Come on. Lovely. Flying. Plenty. Yeah, plenty there. Oh yeah. More. Yes. Come on.
Okay, come on.
Yeah, come on then. Come on. Up. Yeah, that's one. Take it. Come on. Everything. Up. You.
Yes! Yes!
Fabuloso.
Yeah. Cervix time.
So, for anyone that didn't see the Instagram post a week ago, this Smith machine is actually one of my first pieces of equipment. If you don't count the leg press, the hack squat, and the really rough cable stack that I had in the garage, actually cabling took part in several of those sessions. Almost died on a leg press, putting like bricks and stuff on it to make it heavier. So it's one of the first pieces. Just stay tuned is all I'm going to say. I don't know how long it's going to take, but at some point I'll have my own little space. It's not going to be huge, but it's going to be something where I've got some of my most favourite pieces and I can cultivate a really, really cool environment. So, in that stretch position, she's you can see this, so she's pulled her wrist joint outside of a stack position from her elbow joint. So in terms of aligning well for this press and also just aligning well from a safety standpoint, not putting this guy in a compromised position, we want to make sure that we're pretty much having a straight line between the elbow joint and the wrist joint in that stretch position. So just gonna widen her grip out slightly for our work set. Good, strong. Come on. That's it. Brace. Come here. Yeah, press. Yes, good. Ooh. And again. Come on. Press. Up. Yes. There you go. Little touch. Oof. Let's go. Ready?
Oh yeah.
Up!
Come on. Lovely. Oh yeah. Good.
Power, come on.
Come on!
Oh!
Oh yeah, oh. Come on! More. Everything! Oh yeah! More there! Oh!
Ah!
All you! Yes!
Yes! Lovely!
So I haven't got any actual numbers on that particular Smith. They're all obviously very little, have their little differences. But I think my best with two has been like five or six fresh at Ultraflex on their Smith. This one does feel different though, I must admit. And the knurling is slightly different. It feels like almost a bit grippier. But other than that, it's just a Cybex Smith. It feels good. So we're back off sets for anyone that's remotely interested in what we tend to drop. So that's two plates per side. We tend to drop down to 2.5. That's not down. It's up.
2.5.
1.5. So 10 kilos off each side. So if you take that as a percentage, you're looking at sort of cut. Okay, let's go. Power. Yeah. Lovely. Yeah, keep working through. Perfect. And again. Yes, okay, good. Good place to leave it.
Yeah, spot on. Yeah, you're in. Yes. Finish it, yeah.
a much easier way to get out. Just reverse and then stand up.
Yep, that's better.
Jesus, retard.
Yes, dig into this now.
Again.
Still powerful, come on.
Whoa. Yeah. Again, come on, fight through this one.
Now go.
Up. Yes. Right.
Here we go then.
Lovely.
Out.
Yeah, come on then. Yeah. Four.
Good, go. Yep, now. One. Yes, good. Two. Three. Four. Five. Yes, good. Throughout this session, if anyone wants to know the volume so far, so top set back off on the high incline. So just like 6 to 9 and roughly 11 to 15 for most of our top and back offs. Same on the incline Smith, and then same on the narrow grip Smith as well. Now moving on to dumbbell lateral. So we did one heavy set after one warm up. The heavy set we finished with a few partials, just to again try and take that side delt all the way through its contractile range, which means that we do a few partials to challenge the length and position a little bit by shifting our hips back and moving in this motion. Arguably, we're going to get a greater challenge for that on like a lying cuff lateral, which will be later. But yeah, for this movement, it kind of works a little bit. Then we do a really high rep set, followed by what you'll see is like a pretty harsh double drop set into some partner assisted reps. And you'll see by that point that that's how you should do laterals if you really want big delts, really, in my opinion. But you can just, you know, do a few sets at the end of your session, or at the start, you can do a few high rep sets and get a bit of a pump, or you can just take it until you can't feel your delts anymore, and I think that will really show in all of our delt development when we next dive down, is just that we take everything in the session all the way there, not just the main compounds.
Come on then. gun.
Come on.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fuck.
Good, come on. Oh.
Come on then.
There we go. Alright.
Good, come on.
There we are. Good. See your last one. Keep it on. Good. 5, 4, 3, 2, yep. One. Lovely. Drop. Straight in. Out. There. Good.
More. That's it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 1.
Yep.
Come on, then.
Yep. Spot on.
Ah, left side.
Yep, got it.
Good, thank you. Oh.
So this is where the kind of like needs analysis a little bit comes into the session for both me and Caitlin. So Caitlin obviously has no pec deck. She doesn't really need that much chest work. She does need some chest work, definitely some direct work with the pressing, but from a fly perspective, it's just another movement that's adding unnecessary volume to the session, where she's already getting enough sort of total pec work from, like I said, the presses. So sort of prioritizes more of her lateral work, which is fitting the criteria a little bit more for her.
Yeah, come on then. Take it.
Boom.
Yep.
Spot
on. Got it.
Okay.
Cool. So some cues on flies is that a lot of people seem to think that you have to have a straight arm in the stretch position. So you actually don't, and a lot of the time, for most people, it's going to be favourable to have a little bit of elbow flexion, just from a safety standpoint of the shoulder. So I introduced a little bit of elbow flexion in the stretch, but one of the biggest things you need to think about when you're coming into the contraction, into the short, is making sure your arm path is straight. So as you come into the contraction, we want to get, again, a straight line between shoulder joint, elbow joint, wrist joint. That's getting your pec short. Bringing your hands together any further, it's not getting your pec any shorter. Rolling forwards like this, hunching, if anything, is getting your pec less short. So just think about that straight arm path in any contraction with a fly. It's why it tends to be that dumbbells don't work too great for that, because you're getting into a position where holding the dumbbells there at the top is pretty difficult. So that's why I tend to like cables or pec decks. Much better.
Yeah.
Good, lovely. Well done.
Yeah.
4.
So before anyone says,
you're copying Dorian.
Yeah, I am. I am copying Dorian. Who doesn't want to be Dorian, right? Let's see if this makes it any better to stabilize this. Well, now I know why Dorian did that. That's much better. Tomorrow, we'll wake up, jump out of bed. Fucking hell. Oh, look at my arms. The size of Dorian's.
That'll be huge.
Yep. Something to look forward to, isn't it, tomorrow? Alright. If only.
Here we go. Lovely. Yep. Come on. Push it! Yeah, another one. Come on. Brace harder. Down. Down.
Yep.
Yeah. Spot on. Now we're in the groove. Yeah, more there. Yeah. He's flying now. Yeah. Good.
Stay with me.
Come
moving,
on then.
Keep it moving.
Come on then.
You've got to stay close.
Yeah.
Because the clock is what this is. We got the block to top. Man, illusion plus, you got the pussy brewing.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah. Spot on.
Ever tell me I ain't clever.
Yeah.
I ain't never said that, nigga, I ain't ever.
Yeah.
On my knee, I'm dressing up in the states. It's not a body gives a
Yeah, more there. Yep. One. Yep. Yours. Yeah.
Again.
Yeah, come on then. Come on. Your bar.
Stay with.
Come on. I've got you. Everything.
Yep,
spot on.
Finished. Job done. Very good session.
Fantastic.
Sorry to interrupt.
Fantastic session.
Yeah, good one. So I don't know when we will film next, but I definitely think we want to get a density day filmed. I'm just going to have to block out about 4 hours for Alex, so we'll definitely get that in potentially next. I know that a lot of people ask if like a 4 day of eating and things like that, which I personally, like looking at my food, obviously find it very, very dull and boring because it's just the same every day, but I know that people are interested, so potentially we'll get that filmed as well. Some exciting weeks and months coming up as people are starting prep as well. Obviously me, Caitlin and Loz will all be in an off season this year, so we'll just be documenting us getting stronger and stronger and bigger, but there'll be lots of people dieting down, and you know, we've got George Osborne and Jack Thorburn moving up here as well very soon. Keefe's moved a little bit closer, so some potential collabs there, which will be exciting. But yeah, just more of the same from us. We appreciate you watching. Anything else I have to say at all?
No, fantastic session.
Great,
fantastic, yeah. Awesome. Goodbye, guys.